of, you know, the crowd or the opponent. You can't let that take over. If you do allow that, then there's no way you'll play your best.
All right. Missouri takes on number one Alabama tomorrow. Who doesn't want to play number one Alabama? Your Tigers. And it's going to be a 4 p.m. pregame, 6 p.m. kickoff. Heard here on the Big 550 KTRS. Howard Richards on the call. Good morning, Howard Richards.
Good morning, my brother. How are you doing today?
We're doing good. How are you doing?
Listen, I am fall ready. I'm trying to avoid deer on the road and just looking for some great football to watch someplace.
Have you dried out from last week's hour-long delay in that fourth quarter?
Wasn't that a mess? I mean, just I've never seen anything like that ever. Not even really rain delays, the lightning delays. And of all the years of football, never experienced that. I think it had an effect on actually both teams. Seems to obviously favor the home team. Missouri just could not gather. I thought that they had some momentum before the stoppage, and I think they had a better chance to, remain with the flow of their game. But, was not Saturday. Too many mistakes, too many missed opportunities.
Yeah.
So, going into Alabama, the thing that I would hope is that Missouri could find a way to play more complete game, eliminate a lot of the mistakes that, have plagued them, especially against two pretty good teams, Georgia and South Carolina. And just try to play your best down in Tuscaloosa.
Your point is well taken. They played well against Georgia. They played well against – or well enough to win, right, talent-wise. It was just some of the small things that sort of got away from them. So this game on Saturday is not if they play a good – they don't have to play perfect, but they got to play a smart game. They have a chance to win this.
It's about self-destruction. You can't allow yourselves to do that. The silly – personal foul penalties, illegal procedures, jumping off sides. Those types of things are really what slow down your momentum. You're going to have a few drop passes here and there, but, too many, those things are coming in clusters, and that's what you want to avoid. It's about execution. A coach is coach, and they're going to coach your players up, but as a player, you have to take some responsibility and really focus on what you're there to do, and that's for 3.5 hours, play the best football you possibly can.
You also have to not be intimidated by your surroundings, right? I mean, that's going to be probably the biggest issue of all. First time going down to Alabama, number one team, all the pomp and circumstance. You got to stay focused.
No, so true. And not only can you not allow yourself to be intimidated by the environment, you can't allow yourself to be intimidated by the team that you're playing. This could be a similar situation as 2 years ago when Missouri played at LSU. And I think the moment for some of the players, the younger players, was just too big. And, hopefully the Missouri coaching staff will be able to coax its players to, just ignore the noise, prepare like you've always prepared. But this is another football game. You can't, put a name or attach a statistic to the particular team that you're playing. You just got to go out and play the best football you can and hope that after four quarters, in the fourth quarter, you still have a shot at winning a football game.
4 p.m. pregame, 6 p.m. kickoff. Missouri takes on number one Alabama down there. Should be a great call. Howard Richards, enjoy the day. Stay warm, stay dry, and we'll talk all about it next week.
Fantastic. Thanks. Have a good weekend.
You got it.